The light had indeed gone out, but the memory of a man who saw those who were shunned as his children, who encouraged women to enter the mainstream of India's life, who above all believed in universal love, truth and non-violence as the path to free a nation of its alien bonds and ensure its survival, will live forever. As Albert Einstein, the greatest scientist of our age, wrote on Gandhiji's death, generations to come, it may be, will scarce believe that such a one as this, in flesh and blood, walked upon this earth. Gandhi saw a free nation born in travail, as he had feared. He had tried to bring peace, but death overtook him before he could heal the wounds of partition. But history went on, and a nation born a dominion sought to become a proud republic. A constituent assembly was formed, and to its deliberations no greater contribution was made than that by Baba Saab, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Sensing the problems ahead, the issues they would have to consider, Dr. Ambedkar addressed the constituent assembly.
That in order to make a start, in order to induce every party, every section in this country, it would be the act of greatest statesmanship for the majority party even to make a concession to the prejudices of people who are not prepared to march together. And it is for that that I propose to make this appeal. Let us leave aside slogans. Let us leave aside words which frighten people. Let us even make concession to the prejudices of our opponents. Bring them in so that they may willingly join with us on marching upon that road, which, as I said, if we walk long enough, must necessarily lead us to unity.